everybody. This is the free Google Sheets budget template. And in this video today, I'm going to show you how I customize this free template and make it really work for my budget. I think it'll work for you too. And I've structured this video so that you can follow along in real time and set up your monthly budget as well. Now let's get started. Step one is to locate and open this monthly budget template. And when you open Google Sheets from a computer, just look for the monthly budget spreadsheet. It should be located near the top of the screen. But if not, click on Template Gallery, and then you can find the monthly budget under Personal. Let's open it up and we'll continue. Step two is to start with a clean slate. And the first thing you'll want to do here is give the budget template a new name. In the upper left corner, change the name of the spreadsheet from Monthly Budget to Sample Budget to Copy Every Month. And I'm going to explain later on why that's so important. Next, you're going to want to delete the sample amounts on the summary and transaction spreadsheets. But be careful here, if you don't follow my instructions, it could break the formulas in the spreadsheet. Let's begin with the transaction spreadsheet, and you can access that by clicking on the Transactions tab located right at the bottom of the screen. You see the sample expenses for rent and paycheck, and they're there to show you how to use the spreadsheet, but we don't really need them. So what you want to do is click on the number 5 that's to the left of your screen, and it's going to select the entire row. Then make your way to the Edit drop-down menu. You're going to click Delete and then Values. Now make your way to the bottom of the transaction spreadsheet and notice that it ends with row 33. Now that's going to be a problem if you've got more than 33 transactions in a month, and that's likely. So to avoid any issues, just click Add 1,000 more rows at bottom. And now you see you've got 1,033 rows for transactions. Now once you've made those changes, you're going to flip back to the summary spreadsheet. And to start with a clean slate here, first adjust the starting balance in cell L8 from $1,000 to $0. Then we're going to want to zero out the sample home and paycheck amounts. One is on the expenses side, the other on income. First, I've highlighted cell D31, that's home, and I'm going to switch it from $950 to $0 and press Enter. Then do the same in the paycheck cell, that's J29, instead of $1,450, again click $0 and Enter. Everything zeroed out. Now scroll down to the end of the summary spreadsheet. Notice that it ends with row 44. So if you think you may need additional expense categories, and who knows, you may down the road, click Add 1,000 more rows at the bottom, just like you did on that transaction spreadsheet. This time you will get a pop-up that warns about editing the spreadsheet, but go ahead and click OK. And now I've scrolled down to the bottom of the summary page, and there are 1,044 rows. Let's keep it moving. Step three is to customize a sample monthly budget. And we're going to stay toward the bottom of the summary spreadsheet here, because the first thing I want you to do is add a third spreadsheet for fixed expenses. In the lower left corner, click the plus sign for Add Sheet, and then you can change the name of the sheet to Fixed Expenses. I also like to move the sheet to the end after transactions. Then you need just two columns, one for expenses and the other for your projected spending. Now, fixed expenses, they include things like your house payment, cell phone bill, TV bill, utilities, subscriptions, and insurance payments. Some people also like to include irregular expenses here, but really just think about expenses that don't vary too much from month to month. Once you've listed all your fixed expenses, highlight the values in the projected column, and then go to the upper right corner. You see here it says Functions. The first option is Sum. Then you'll click Enter, and it'll total all the values in the projected column for you. Remember your total and now flip back to the summary spreadsheet. Make your way to the top of the spreadsheet and then change the first line on the expenses column from food to fixed expenses. And then you're going to enter the total from the fixed expenses worksheet that you just made. Put that total in the planned column. The great thing about this is now all of your fixed expenses only take up one line on the summary spreadsheet. And why is that important anyway? What allows you to focus more on the variable or flexible spending categories that have a greater impact on your day-to-day spending. So let's talk more about those. Now's the time in the process where you can customize your categories, and you can safely change the shaded expense and income categories on the summary spreadsheet through line 41. But don't fill in the planned column for any of your expense categories, at least not yet, that's later. The only exception is fixed expenses, which we just did. So if you're creating your budget in real time as you're watching this video, you may want to pause it so you can take a little time to determine your spending categories. You can always review some credit card or bank statements to help you figure those out. I've scrolled down the summary spreadsheet to make a very important point because this is where a lot of people get tripped up. You see on the expenses side, they end with row 41, but what happens if you need additional rows? Pay close attention, there's a specific way to add rows so you don't mess up the formulas. First, you'll go to the last row of the expense column, that's line 41, and mine is still called Custom Category 3. You may have renamed yours by now, that's okay. Then watch as I highlight the cells that I want to duplicate. Next, you're going to drag down using the blue handle to add the desired number of rows. You can add as many as you want, but I added 9 rows so that I stopped on row 50, and I do recommend that for simplicity. You'll see why later on. Then just click OK when you're prompted with this pop-up warning, and then you can continue. At this point, you see the new categories are there, and you can rename them whatever you want to call them. After that, just jot down the last row that you created. Now we'll flip over to the Transactions tab to continue. I'm at the top of the Transactions tab and I've navigated to the Category dropdown. That is an E5. When I click on the dropdown, you'll notice that not all of the new categories are reflected here. Remember, it ended with Custom Category 12 in my example, but it doesn't show that category on the screen. So let's fix that. First, you're going to highlight the cell under Category on the Expenses side. So that's Row 5 and Column E. From the data menu at the top of the screen, select Data Validation. And now to the right of the screen, it should say Data Validation Rules. There's two options here. Select the one at the top with the E values. Now make your way down to the Criteria Summary field, and you see the formula with the dollar signs and summary. Well, to the right of that, it says Select Data Range. Click on that. And here, all you got to do is change the last two numbers of this formula. You want it to match the number of your last row from the summary spreadsheet. So that was 50, as I previously mentioned. I'm going to change it from 44 to 50, and then select OK. After that, click Done at the bottom of the Data Validation Rules screen, then go back to the Category dropdown on the Transactions tab and make sure that all of your categories appear. Custom Category 12 is there, so this worked. Step 4 is to make a copy of the sample budget and plan your spending. We're making fast progress here. For this step, first go to the File menu, then select Make a Copy and rename the budget for the upcoming month. So for this example, I'm going to use January 2023 budget. I go back to the sample budget every single month to make a new copy. And as you see here, all the categories and the fixed expenses spreadsheet have been copied over automatically. Now from here, there are two things you want to do from the summary spreadsheet. First, plan your spending in all your categories. That's on the expenses side. And second, estimate your paychecks and other income sources on the income side. So now that we're on the actual monthly budget and not the sample, you can go ahead and enter your numbers in the planned column. And of course, your goal is to have your estimated monthly income be greater than or equal to all of your planned expenses. And this is important. If you need to make tweaks to your categories or the fixed expenses spreadsheet anytime in the future, make those changes to the sample budget before you make a copy. That's going to save you time. And by creating that sample budget, you don't need to tweak the formulas every single month. It really simplifies the process. Step number 5, the most important step, is to track your expenses throughout the month. And really the key to making this budget work is tracking your expenses throughout the month using the transaction spreadsheet. The first transaction that I log every month is for my fixed expenses. So I just enter the total from the fixed expenses worksheet on the Transactions tab, and this will update the actual column for the fixed expenses category on the summary spreadsheet. Now, after that transaction, I really tend to do most of my budgeting on the go with the Google Sheets mobile app. It's free, and from the app, I can get an overall snapshot of my spending from the summary spreadsheet, and I enter transactions on the transaction spreadsheet. So here's an example. Before I go to the grocery store, I'll open up the Google Sheets app, and I'll look at the summary tab to see how much money I've got left to spend. In this case, $500 remaining in the groceries category because it's the beginning of the month. And then after completing my purchase at the store, I immediately record the transaction before I even leave the store or the parking lot. To do that, I'll just flip over to the Transactions tab, enter the date, amount, description, and category. And then when I go back to the Summary tab, that recent transaction is reflected. After spending $100, I can see that I now have $400 left to spend on groceries for the month. Checking in with my budget before every purchase, that's really my secret weapon, and it saved me a lot of money. This is, of course, very easy with the mobile app, but if you prefer to do all of your work on the computer, that's fine. You got to do what works for you. You can always log your transactions using a computer as well. And another great thing about this budget is that you can share it. Do that in the upper right corner. So if you maintain a budget with a partner, you can both make changes to the same budget from either your computer, tablet, or smartphone. Give this video a like if you found it helpful, and you can find more of my budgeting content on michaelsaves.com. Thanks a lot for watching.